guys? How you doing? This is Misunderstood with The Drive on Olive Entertainment.
Today's guest is La Sizwe, all the way from South Africa, and we get to talk about all his favorite things, have a little bit of kapana, show him around Vintage City, and of course get to know him a little bit.
Yes.
Oh my god,
hi.
Is this like your plane?
Hi, yes, this is my place. Welcome, welcome. How you doing?
I'm okay. There you go. You're giving me French vibes.
Yes, so French. So how are you doing, man?
I'm good, thanks. How are you?
I'm okay. Welcome to the land of the brave. Welcome to Namibia.
The land of the brave. Why do you guys call Namibia the land of the brave?
Because, you know, during apartheid, the people who fought for our independence, we call them, you know, brave warriors.
Oh.
And our soccer team is also called the brave warriors. So we're known as the land of the brave ones.
Okay. Oh. Mm-hmm. 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 Okay.
Okay. So tell me, how's your time been here so far?
Listen, it has been... The definition of labels, like literally Namibia has blown my mind.
Oh,
I'm
glad.
The amount of love I'm receiving in the country, mm-hmm. the amount of experiences. I mean, we come from, what is that place called again?
Oh, single quarters. We're Kapana.
Kapana.
The Kapana, the meat-uations.
You understand that if you go around the whole of Kapana, you'll be full. Just tasting.
Mm-hmm. One by one.
Yeah.
So in your time here, have you seen anything that has inspired you, a funny video or anything Namibian?
Listen, your guys' accent is the one I love.
Our like, accent?
Yes. Mm-hmm. You guys have that Beyonce accent.
Ooh.
Like you're like, our accent.
Yes, our accent.
Not accent. It has that thing, you know, you understand?
Mm-hmm. Mm. No, that's making sense. And are you planning on coming back here? Or?
Definitely, I'm planning to come back with a lot of my friends and my family. I want to go to the desert.
Yes,
I want to bring them to the desert, darling, and take desert pictures. And just for the experience and the vibe, I think my stay in Namibia has been very short, so I want to spend like a good 2 days, 3 days here.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So you said that you were getting a lot of, you know, attention, a lot of questions while you were here. I want to know, how do you, as someone who is so big, how do you maintain like a level head? How do you stay down to earth?
I just think of the people I impact, and at the end of the day, you know, I can be as big as I am and the biggest celebrity, whatever, but at the end of the day, we're all humans, you know, and that's something that I fully respect, is that I may be Beyonce, but Beyonce is still human. If she sees me, she still needs to respect me.
Mm-hmm.
So for me, it boils down to that, whether you have criticism or compliments, you are humans.
And you've been, you know, steadily building your brand for the last few years. What can you say you've learned as a media personality? What have you learned about yourself?
What have I learned about myself? I know everyone says this, like, stay true to yourself. Stay true. That's like something that you really need to do.
That's
like
rule number one.
That's rule number one. And it sounds easy, but it's actually the most difficult thing ever, because
I can imagine.
You ask yourself, how is it to stay true to yourself? Like, what is it to stay true to yourself? So it means like genuinely just digging down deep and finding what makes you happy.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. What does make you happy?
Food.
Yes!
Men.
Yes! Yes! Okay, I see you.
And Namibian men.
Ooh, did you? Ooh, whoa,
chill.
Whoa.
Chill, let me tell
so
you.
So you've been seeing Namibian men?
No.
Any cute ones?
I've been washing my eyes. Uh-huh, you know when they say you're showering your eyes? I've been washing my eyes and like, damn, you guys have got good men.
Oh,
but
no, yeah.
Like, but on Twitter, you guys are like, no, your men are trash, wada, fish pay.
But I mean, you know, man, let me not get too political. But I think we have handsome men in Namibia. We got some good men. I mean, if I'm thinking of Sadek, I'll say Namibia's, you know, we're doing good. We're
top
doing
10.
Good. Top 10?
Top 10.
Okay, who's,
top 10.
Okay, who in Sadek is in your top 3?
My country's men are beautiful. Nigeria's men
Ooh,
are beautiful.
Yes! Oh, shout out Nigeria.
Nigeria. Namibian men.
Amen.
And Tanzanian.
Ooh.
Tanzanian.
Yes, that East African.
Anytime.
Any time of the day. Yes,
I'm joking. Whoa, guys. PG.
It's taking a whole lot of it.
Taking a whole lot of it, yeah.
Do you have any like mantras or anything you repeat to yourself to sort of something that you want to always remember?
It's something that I always try to remember is the person I'm becoming and the person I am. You know, everyone's like, oh, you're a celebrity, but I don't see myself as a celebrity. I see myself as a counselor. I see myself as someone who is like a therapist, because you go in there sad and you come out laughing.
Yeah.
So for me, that's who I am and what I want to become. I want to motivate you and make you smile and make you happy. When you see me, you must be happy. You must be excited to see me, you know.
So how did you get into videos, if I may ask, just for those people who might not know exactly, how did you get into being this funny personality that's making
funny,
people laugh?
I started doing videos 3 years ago, 3-4 years ago, because I always wanted to be on TV, but the opportunity never came. So I decided that, you know, I'll make my own, you know, platform.
Make your own path.
Sometimes when you knock on the doors and they don't open, just break down the doors, babe. Just you'll see when you get there.
Yes.
So I literally put my phone in the window and stick it with plastic, do what I gotta do, and pretend like there's people behind the camera. And boom, one day,
boom,
it just in the fence. So
yes. And at what moment was there one moment where you were like, I'm funny?
Not even, like, even till this day, like, sometimes I'm like, is this you? Are you funny? Like, I don't find myself funny sometimes. Like, I'd be like, like sometimes people be like one of my videos is sitting on 1.1 million views.
Wow.
And, like, everyone was like, oh my gosh, you're so funny. But when I watched that video, I'm like, this is not funny.
Yeah.
Like, oh,
no, you're critiquing yourself.
Yeah, like, sometimes I critique myself. But there are moments where I'm like, I'm funny, but when I think I'm funny, I'm not funny.
Mm-hmm. And so what do you want to do in future? What path would you say that you're heading in?
Because
I know, I'm sure there must be so many.
I want to be pregnant.
Oh, yes.
I want to be pregnant.
Uh-huh.
I want to be pregnant. I don't know how. We'll make it happen.
It'll happen.
We're going to make it work.
It's
going to
be a beautiful
baby. It's going to be
a
beautiful
baby.
My baby.
Like a baby. Let's
Have you ever seen women with baby bumps? Like,
yes.
They look so gorgeous.
Do you know what I always say? I'm always like, if I have a baby, I'm having a celebrity baby. Otherwise, I don't want that baby.
Yeah, no. Same here. Like my baby got to make me a million.
Nah, you got to be like that Carol Forbes baby.
Yeah,
with the endorsements.
All of immediately when I push, I don't know where I'm gonna push. Okay, C-section, you know.
Yeah.
But immediately when they cut the baby, like my stomach.
I feel like if we can get the baby in, there'll be a way to get the baby out.
Hey, can you understand? Thank you. So when the baby is in there, like when it's out and stuff, like from 3 days, must have an endorsement. A week, she must have sponsorship. When the baby's 3 months old, must have an album.
You can't just be here not working, eating and crying. Gotta bring the bag in.
My baby must have a text number from 3 days. I must go register
already.
It. Must have fingerprints.
Company.
Okay.
Baby La Sizwe CC.
Thank
you.
PTY LTD. Okay. You understand?
That is so, so dope. You know, Namibia is a very small country, and we have a lot of people who are trying to also be, you know, personalities, and we're doing media and stuff, but we don't have, like, the views that, you know, someone in SA might get. What suggestion would you say that you have for people in Namibia who want to be out there and want to have their face out there, but what suggestion do you have for them to push their content?
For me, it's start at home. Like, start with your friends, your families, your auntie cousins, for them to know who you are and what you do.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's very important. You know, everyone keeps on saying, oh, I want to be famous. But you have to be famous within your circle to grow your circle. Because what happens is, when you tell your friend tells another friend, and their other friend tells the other friend. The other friend tells their work colleagues and all of those things. And that's how you grow and become big. So it starts with the micro, then it becomes micro, and then it becomes micro, microwave.
So you just have to be consistent and
be
keep
very consistent and be aware of, like, your surroundings, the society, what is trending, what's not trending, because that benefits and impacts a lot of things. Yeah,
I'm sure you now have access to so many things that you didn't have access to before. Mm-hmm. What would you say is your favorite thing about this lifestyle?
I can get any man I want. I'm joking. I wish. I think with my what access I have is meeting new people.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I just met you. I go to cool countries.
Yeah.
I get to travel. I get to inspire and motivate just by being myself. Mm-hmm. And I get to teach, which is something very big, you know. Yeah. So, like, it's just, it's pretty cool.
Okay, okay. Where has been your favorite place to be in Namibia? Or your favorite thing to have done? I know you were only here for...
A day.
Yeah.
My favorite place, oh my gosh. My favorite place. The hotel that I stay in.
Ah, nice. Okay.
The Marigold Hotel. Marigold Hotel is top two and not two. That hotel, like, it even beats some Johannesburg hotels. Like, mm-hmm. It would sit, like, in top five in Johannesburg.
Okay. Yeah. I like that. We need to, you know, wrap up this interview. I'm getting looks from my directors. But can you just quickly do, let me ask you, like, quick questions and you answer as quickly as possible. What's your favorite color?
Blue.
What's your favorite smell?
Musk. Men.
What's your favorite part of your body?
Men.
Your favorite part of your body is men.
Yeah.
And that's a wrap, guys. This has been amazing. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you for having me.
I hope you enjoyed your time in Namibia.
We do it like amazing. The Paris people.
Yeah, it's like
and you smell amazing.